Hello and welcome back.
This is cookie.
Cookie with chocolates. Yes, I need to put more light on this. It's close to 6:30 p.m. and I'm almost finished uploading my videos. Let's eat this cookie. It's finished charging. But this camcorder. This camcorder is not good to record text like this. You can barely read it. But I have charging this battery. So actually we could fly a little bit here. But that's not a toy drone, that's a drone that can really make serious damage. This FPV racer drone, so... But why not? We should do it now before it's too late. And I cannot sit down because I maybe have to move away very fast, so I cannot just sit here. I'm not going to sit here and like fly like this, because maybe I have to move away very fast if I lose control. But I'm not going to fly around. I'm just put the drone. The drone need to stay around here. I'm not going to fly around in my apartment. Of course, I have a big tent here. I have a big tent to use for my videos here. And this is stuff from my basement. I have totally empty my basement. So that's stuff from my basement. This is some Christmas decorations. This box is glass, drinking glass, all kind of glass. All this box is kind of wires, electric wires. Something for paint, all kinds of stuff. That's for my food, soap. Soap and food should not be here, but I have no space. Yes, that's more food. But let's make the drone ready. We need to charge it again, but I got a timeout because I put this to 0.5A. No, 0.5 amperes. I have changed it to 0.8. I think 0.5 is too low. I was getting a timeout. And I need to charge this battery too. But let's make the drone ready. So we just charge it again. But we can fly a few minutes. No, that was too slow charging. So first we put first you need you have some Velcro, something I put myself. There's some Velcro with tape, so the battery not sliding around. So I have some Velcro here. So first you just put the drone there. I think the battery not this battery is not finish good because it's a little bit swollen. This battery should not be like that. I probably have to throw this battery out, but we don't do now. First we need to secure the... But you have all kind of stuff below here. You have some wires to the controller and stuff, so you cannot just put it everywhere. I think you have to put it down below here. Now drop it on the floor. I do that always. You probably have to take it out again, because I always turn it wrong way, you know. Yes, this Velcro needs to be outside, because I have to do it like here. I have to... The Velcro needs to be this, like this. Now I have secured the battery. Now we have to put the buzzer on. The buzzer is I think it should be 3.5, but I think I put it above 3.6. I think they put the buzzer to 3.6. That should maybe be 3.5. I not remember how to change that. I'll do that later. I think you have some bottom somewhere. You press a bottom somewhere. Yes. Then we need my controller. Yes, but this is not a toy drone. That can really make some damage if it's hitting your fingers or your eyes and stuff. So that cannot happen. That's 3 years ago, 3 or 4 years ago, I'm really flying with that. That's my transmitter we take on my neck here. And we just wait to turn the transmitter on, but you can always have some damage. You got some LED light. You can always have some something not working with the drone. The propeller could start by accident. So we just put the drone here on the floor. And I'll put the camcorder like here. The microphone is not very good, but this is action cam, it's a very wide angle, so actually it can record a lot. But I don't remember how to unlock the... Yes, you have to unlock the engines. It's already bad.
Yes. Just say you should never do this. If you don't know how to fly a drone, you should never fly. You should never fly inside because that's very dangerous. This propeller can make you a lot of damage. So I just want to say that if you don't know how to fly a drone, never do this. Because it's actually a little bit dangerous.